Hello everyone, Sasrikal. Welcome back to my channel. So today I am heading towards a new place which is one of the hot tourist spots in Toronto, which is Toronto Islands. It's been an year that I have been in Canada and I have been living in downtown Toronto, but I have never ever visited Toronto Islands. So today I did not want to lose the opportunity of not going. So it's a Saturday, we are all set to go to Toronto Islands, but first we need to withdraw some money from CIBC because we can go to Toronto Islands through a ferry which is here called as Tiki Taxi. So we need to pay cash there, so that's the reason we're just withdrawing cash. Downtown Toronto from the lakeshore, so we just stay like 200 meters away from the lakeshore. So we are lucky enough that we don't have to travel, we are just walking towards the Tiki Taxi, and we have to pay cash there, around I think $10 per person, and we should be good to go for the Toronto Islands then. So we're just walking, we don't have to take any public transport, and yeah, good sunny weather. Beautiful, beautiful day. So stay tuned with me to see the Toronto Islands from my eyes.
I'm sure I've seen you in my dreams. I'm feeling like in the first time we ever meet. You make the time feel slow, so just like slow reverse.
Okay, so there are a lot of different islands here. So one of them is Naked Beach, one of them is Family Beach, and another one. So we are just trying to figure out which one is the best, island that we should go. There's a huge, huge lineup, and you can see behind me. So this is the taxi that we'll be taking. This one. So this is called Tiki Taxi. It's like a ferry which takes you to the island, and so look at the lineup. Look at that, there's a huge lineup, and it is super, super hot.
Okay, so we've just got to know that there's another way of going to Toronto Islands, and that is by the way of ferries, which just move from the other dock, which is the Queen's Quay dock, located between Bay Street and Yonge Street on Queen's Quay. They are basically called the Jack Layton Ferry Terminal. So ferry tickets are purchased on the site at the terminal, or they can be purchased online. The ferry tickets are much cheaper, to my surprise, and they are around $8. Including the return ticket, so that's both way. And for the adults, for children under 2 it's free, and for students and seniors it's around $6. So wherein the Tiki Taxi is quite expensive, it is $10 one way, so actually per person you're spending $20. So because Corona is going, so we prefer that we take Tiki Taxi because less number of people in the Tiki Taxi, and these taxis have also mentioned are not careful about measures being taken because of coronavirus. So and I am glad to share that proper measures were taken with regards to everybody's safety. Before we entered the Tiki Taxi, our hands were sanitized, The seats of the entire Tiki Taxi were disinfected with the spray. Everybody was asked to wear face masks before they enter the Tiki Taxi, and also people who are family are allowed to sit next to each other. No wonder why Canada is the safest country to be in during COVID.
So we have to come here?
You have to come here, yeah, sure.
You ready? Yeah, let's ride. Come on. Yeah.
This is called Centre Islands, where we are. There are three islands which make the total of Toronto Islands. One is Centre Islands, where we are standing right now. Second is Rods Beach. The third island, which is here, is called Henlands Island. Again, 3.5 kilometers from here. So we will keep walking and see that. Keep exploring. You can see there is no sign of coronavirus here. People are chilling, enjoying. People are playing the frisbee, and there are people who have got their mats, umbrellas, and even their boats, and they're making the most of a sunny day. So let's get ahead and see what we see more. Let's explore. And if you like my channel and want to see more insights on Canada and life in Canada, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So let's see what's ahead. Organized. You can see there are changing rooms there. So there will be washrooms, changing rooms, a lot of places to eat, renting bicycles. So this way Canada with tourism is fantastic, and everything is super, super organized.
So it's so hot that we are really, really thirsty and we want to drink something. So these are two bar stations where we are heading towards to grab our drinks. And we cannot move out, so we have to sit and drink here.
Being an Indian, I would prefer being in my AC room during this time, but people here are crazy. You can see all around that people are cycling, they're swimming, chilling around, sitting in the hot sand. I am getting a little bit agitated with the sun, but seeing people here making the most of summer is something that you will see in Canadians the more.
Hi guys, from where did you get this?
Sorry?
Where did you get this?
Center, like somewhere that way, like 5 minutes away.
We have to walk like a lot.
I think they close at 5 though.
Sorry?
They close at 5 o'clock.
Oh, they close at 5?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, thank you.
So after seeing those guys riding the bike, I am excited, and I have got my husband to the bicycle renting terminal, and it just closes at 5, so let's see if we get our quad cycle or not. And do you see this? Toronto Island is so huge. Many parts of this island are closed because of COVID. There's an amusement park for the kids as well, which is also closed because of coronavirus. So I don't think so we'll be able to cover that much.
Looking at the Raya, the two-seater quad cycle.
Stay here.
30 minutes?
So we have rented the quad cycle, which is $18 for an hour, and you can rent a bicycle, which is like $16 an hour, or a four-seater a cycle, which is like $32 an hour. So they only take cash deposits, and you have to return the cycle in an hour. This is the quad cycle, and now I'm going to show you how are they carefully disinfecting every cycle that they're getting.
So we have finally got our bike. So what do you call this?
Quad cycle.
So there are two seaters and there are four seaters. So we have taken a two seater. The wait was not too long. About 20 minutes, 15 minutes I would say. And yeah. So it's a convenient. Yeah, so we are now headed towards, it's much easier for us to ride now because it was too hot and I was not in to walk at all. So, this is quite good. Now we are heading back and we want to eat something. So there is this beer place where we'll see if we can sit and eat. So if not, then we will be taking our ferry back to downtown and we might eat something there. Lots of riding of the bike, and now we are sitting at one of the patios which is just on the island, called as Toronto Island Barbecue and Beer Company. So we'll be chilling here for some time. Beautiful view, I will just show you around. It's a beautiful, beautiful view. Feeling quite nice now because it's just close to the water. So we're gonna do some, you know, double dip.
Eating.
We're good, thank you. So our food is there, quick service.
So this is the ferry that I was talking about, which is $8 including the return ticket from Queen Square Dock. And this is the beautiful view of CN Tower from the island. Thank you.